Greetings, humans. Spinning Mantis here with another game review. We're talking about my favorite games, the best games of 2015 to 2017. And this one is Batman the Telltale series. A very, very good game by Telltale Games. Season 2 just came out. It's got a different name, but if you want to check out season one, you might be able to get it on discount. It is an excellent game all around, especially for the story. The action makes sense. The action is some of the best action in Telltale game of anyone that I've played. A lot of them, other ones just seem like pointless quick time events, but Batman obviously has a lot of combat and it makes sense. So combat and the control system works out really good, as does the detective system. And there is Catwoman. Catwoman in this game is very good, very cool. You can have a more in-depth relationship with her. Really like it. So let's get down to some of the ratings. I have given it an 8 for graphics. I really like the style. It is semi-realistic. Like most of the Telltale games, I like their spin on Batman. The characters are really, really well done. But you don't necessarily come to these games for graphics. You come for other things. Gameplay, I give it a 7. I always give all Telltale games a 7 because essentially they are quick time events, dialogue, and stuff like that. There's nothing groundbreaking going on as far as gameplay goes. You can see it's these button combos, things slow down through the action, and then a lot of dialogue choices. So I will always give a Telltale game a 7 as far as gameplay goes. So that's the lowest score for this, because the rest of the game is great. For story, I give it a 9. It's a completely different Batman story. I cannot say much about it without spoilers, but there's all sorts of things going on with multiple villains. Two-Face, Scarecrow, obviously you can see Catwoman is in it, but the story is very complex and goes in a different direction that apparently no Batman comic or film has gone before. So it's a completely different sort of Batman universe. I gave it a 9 out of 10 as far as story goes. It really kept me engaged and makes me excited for the new season, which hopefully I'll be playing on this channel sometime soon. And hopefully there will be more Catwoman, because she was a standout part of this series, the first one, Batman, the Telltale series. Fun. I gave it an 8 out of 10. I did have a lot of fun playing it. The story has a lot of good twists and turns. There's some good decisions you can make that actually do affect what happens in the game. But, you know, it was fun overall. I'm not the hugest Batman fan, but I really was engaged in this Telltale game more than a lot of other ones that I've played recently. So that says a lot for it. And I definitely couldn't wait for the next episode to come out and see how the story was going to turn out. So that overall gives the game an average of an 8 out of 10, which is very, very, very good. I do highly recommend it. You should be able to get it for something like $20 now. It'll be 5 episodes. Each one is an hour and a half to 2 hours long. I think it's well worth it. Really top-notch kind of stuff. So Batman the Telltale series, worth your time if you're a Batman fan, if you're a fan of Telltale games, if you're a fan of a good story in a game and a cool stylized look. It's like you're playing through an episode of a really cool new Batman cartoon show on television. But definitely check this one out, and the second season, which I don't know what's going to go on in it, but I have high hopes for it. So anyway, that is going to be all for now. I hope you have found this interesting and informative. That's going to be all for now. Spinning Mantis out. Namaste.